This is the same military establishment who lined up and formed a pretty big consensus over Iraq. It was about regime change. It wasn't really ever about weapons of mass destruction, and I bet Blair regrets having ever made that argument. But it was about regime change, and sure enough, we toppled Saddam Hussein. And then we go fast forward a few years to Libya, where virtually nobody in the House of Commons stood up and thought it was a bad idea to attack Libya. I have to say, I thought it was one of the worst foreign policy decisions we've ever taken, and I wasn't shy in saying so at the time. Undoubtedly, we have made Libya a far worse place than it was under Gaddafi, and Iraq. I mean, how many hundreds of thousands of people have died in Iraq, and there's still no real proper settlement in sight. You know, we intervene, we get rid of these Arab nationalist dictators because we think it's the right thing to do, having never thought through what the long-term consequences are. Look, I don't know whether Assad used these chemical weapons or not. I don't know why he would, given that he's winning the war anyway. But maybe it was him. But even if we knew it was him, and we decided, right, we are going to attack military bases, attack the palace, if the result of concerted action with us, the Americans, and the French results in the overthrow of Assad, is that the right thing for us to do? Well, we may think morally it is the right thing to do because of some of the horrible, awful things that he's done. But ask yourselves a question. What comes next? Chaos, instability, and who's to say, maybe a chance for ISIS to build their forces again. So I would say, even if tomorrow Trump attacks, not waiting for a UN resolution. He didn't last year, after all. I don't think we should join. And even if we got a UN resolution, I would still be very, very thoughtful about this. What, in the longer term, are we actually trying to achieve?